If you're going to be driving the all-new Subaru Crosstrek, this is what the action will look like. First of all, start her up and it sounds like this. Now with the new Crosstrek, what you're also going to be getting are softer seats. The softer seats are a nice touch, but it's also durable and easy to clean, proving to show how this is very complementary to your adventurous personality. Now the seats are also softer, which also does give you less vibrations, especially if you're going to be taking those nice and long drives. To add more comfort to your overall road trip experience with the Crosstrek is right here in the middle. When you look at the middle of your screen, initially this might be a little bit polarizing. Some people like the large screen, but some people really don't. It's really preference at the end of the day. But one thing I gotta point out in terms of the center screen for the all-new Crosstrek is that it's gonna be very easy to learn. Now there's so much information about your center screen here, which proves to show how this is an easy car to have around. But if you're gonna be looking for physical buttons, you'll like that there are still physical buttons on the left and on the right side of your screen. The physical buttons are there mostly for your climate and as well as for your audio. But in terms of your touchscreen, you'll like the idea that your climate also has a consistent touch down below. Regardless of how you customize your ride, this will be consistent. In terms of your touchscreen, what you also have here is Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. And what's interesting about your center screen though, is that there are certain features about the car, like let's say your auto start stop function, and as well as your auto vehicle hold and your traction control are all accessible right here on your center screen. But what I also like about this car though, is that you also have access to X mode. Now, what is X mode? X mode is basically like the four-wheel drive system of the Subaru Crosstrek. It already has symmetrical all-wheel drive, so why would you need four-wheel drive? Well, technically it's not four-wheel drive because you're always on all-wheel drive, but what happens though is that the car adjusts itself ever so slightly if in case you might have some more off-road action. Now, your X mode will be accessible here up on top along with other personalized items. And if you're gonna be going on X mode, I recommend that you press car info so that you can see the under chassis and the overall angulation of your car. You're gonna see more details of that. Now, what's also nice about this center screen is that the maintenance records and as well as the overall bird's eye point of view of your ride can be seen right here. How the health is for your engine oil, how the health is for your filter and tires, it could be all set right here. It's very intuitive, but it's also very simple. Now, speaking of simple, down below, if you need to charge and you don't have a wire, you're gonna like this little touch here. You have a wireless charging pad. Down below is your CVT transmission and as well as your electronic parking brake. Now, in terms of your dashboard, you'll like the touch here for your Subaru Crosstrek in a sense that it's gonna be easy to clean. And down below, you have a bit of a sporty touch here, especially with the carbon fiber trims, which extend all the way to your door panels. Now, in terms of your driver's display, what you have is a mix of digital and analog. Analog in a sense of your tachometer and your speedometer, but digital for, like, let's say, your average fuel economy, and as well as other information that you might see from here, which could reflect all the way to your driver's display. Now, complementing your driver's display is your steering wheel. When you look at your wheel, initially, it might feel a little bit busy with all of the buttons, but after a good day or two with your Subaru, this is gonna be easy to have. First things first, the buttons on your left here are all controls for your audio, and the buttons on your right here are all gonna be controls for how you drive your car. Whether you adjust your drive mode, whether you activate your adaptive cruise control, and if you want more fun with your ride, you could always activate the manual mode and use your paddle shifters here in the Crosstrek. The minute I got in, one thing I have to point out about this crossover is that the doors open pretty wide, so getting in and getting out won't be a concern for this ride, whether you're the driver or whether you're the passenger. As you can see, it's a bench-type seating here in the back, and the fabrics for these seats are nice, soft, and durable. And so if, let's say, you're gonna be going on trips where, let's say, your clothes get dirty, again, you won't feel guilty getting these seats dirty because it's gonna be easy to clean in the long run. With that, in the back, as you can see, there's a good amount of practicality here in the back in a sense of your cargo capacity. Now, your cargo capacity, I showed that to you earlier today, but what's nice about the back here in the middle is that the seats actually fold in a 60-40 configuration. Pull this tab up here, and that allows this seat to fold flat, and so you have access to rear cargo. This is ideal if there's only going to be three passengers. But if you don't need all that space, you could be able to keep this up here, and as you can see, you have access to three seats. Now, with the seats in place, as you can see, you could be able to sit comfortably here in the back as an adult, but if you're gonna be having little kids here in the back, you'll also like the idea that the Isofix tethers are easily accessible, so you could be able to have kids traveling here in the back with you. So with that, we've talked about what the Crosstrek's like from the front and the back, the cargo, the engine, and everything else all about it. Now it's time for us to move back to the driver's seat and get this car out on an adventure.